Fucking all right.
You laugh now.
You guys. In 3, 2, 1, hey! Fucking relax as shit compared to the last one.
Yeah.
Fucking welcome to Badger's Burrow podcast number 41.
Is this 41?
It is 41.
Huh.
No, sorry. Take that back. It's 42. Just checked it.
What?
Welcome, Badger's Burrow. Nah, fuck it.
Just well, can you tell us to get that shit out and you do it immediately?
Yeah.
Nah, it's just like I started saying it and then I was like, nah, fuck it, this can all just stay in. I fucked it. So it can just stay.
Oh, a likely story.
I've had an adventure today.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, do tell.
Well, I can't tell all parts of the adventure just yet.
Or why?
For reasons that will become obvious to you guys in the near future. But for the sake of it, I won't tell every piece. But I did see Fat Ross today. I've seen
that means nothing to me.
No, I've seen like a lot of doubles today of people that I know and.
Fat. Oh right, I thought you meant like a guy who you know is called Ross, but is also fat.
No.
Fairly skinny Ross.
No, like genuinely, like I had to do a double take because like this guy, like I was in Perth on my way back home. And this guy genuinely looked like the fucking spitting image of Ross, but just like a foot taller and really fat.
Uh-huh.
Is that like the Happy Stephen you've seen?
Yeah, kind of like that, yeah. Oh, fuck. It's the doppelgangers. We're finding them all. But like, no, genuinely, like, Ross, everything. Like, he had like the really short, black, like, really, like, curly, afro-y hair.
Uh-huh.
Exactly your beard and near enough your fucking face. Like, yeah. I genuinely did a double take because I was like, when the fuck did Ross grow that much? Because at first I took in the fact that he was like a good foot taller, and then I realised that he was also like, he wasn't like fat, but he had a fucking huge beer belly on him.
Yeah.
And I was just like, that's really fucking weird. So I've now found the fat version of you.
Sweet. Nice to know I'm not the fat version of me.
That's how you want to come out in that fucking situation.
Yeah, exactly.
Not be the fat one.
You don't want to have start that conversation with, I found the skinny version of you today.
Fucking someone said that to me once, so I almost hit them. But you're
like,
cunt,
I'm sorry.
Fucking Ross, you texting me earlier today was a fucking funny as well, because you were like, see on a work he texts me, see on a work related note, did you finish uploading that video?
Yeah, go tell me the fucking messages in you afterwards.
Do you mean the one before it or
no, the one that's not work related?
The one that's not work related.
Just under it.
Oh yeah. First of all, he said, did you finish uploading your part twos of that video? I've got the new intro, but not those. They're not in the OneDrive. So I said I'd turn my computer on and finish uploading it, as I did, and that video is now there.
Yeah, I'll get it after this.
And later on, he texts me and he just said, also not work-related, I just took the most devastating poop ever. And he says, children in war-torn Africa are crying for my anus right now.
Fuck's sake.
It was a bad one, man.
I was semi considering not reading that bit out, but then I was like, fuck it, who the shit is listening to this?
Yeah, exactly. Fucking cares.
Fucking speaking of the new intro, we just finally decided on music for it.
I know, yeah.
Like literally 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, and I've put it up on the Facebook page.
Oh, have you really?
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
I can't wait.
I can't.
What's actually that page you've seen in fucking months?
So Facebook will suffice.
Fucking speaking of that, I mean, Chatterblock Season 2.
Yeah.
That's a whole thing. I can't.
I need to play fucking Minecraft again.
Yep.
Yeah, you do.
For another year.
Well, no, just another year's worth of content. Not
so like, knowing how we done Chatterblocks the first time, we'll knock it out in like a week.
Yeah, we just need this.
And I'll be a salty prick for that week, but
fucking,
it'll be a week.
In a way, I really fucking hope that we don't knock it out in a week.
Yeah,
I do. I want it fucking over and done with.
I want it over and done with as well because it's
fucking
such an easy series to do. Now we should plan. Let's sit down. Let's say like by the end of this week or next week, and actually do at least a couple of videos worth.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alex, it's not even like we're building shit. It's literally just.
No.
Yeah. Now we're going on to the playing side of things. We spent a whole year just building fucking stuff.
No, we spent a week just building shit and then putting it out over the space of a year.
Yeah.
The difference.
It was all filmed in January.
It was genuinely, yeah.
It was all edited by March.
Fucking, I need to fucking get off my ass and start putting a plan out for the best of as well. Don't know why I'm not in the biggest rush to make sure it gets out for like the actual anniversary. Just if it comes out some point in February, I'm happy. So I've got.
Was that in general, Barbie?
Yeah, exactly. Like fucking, it'll take a wee while. I actually reckon this last year's best of video might be a little shorter than the one before.
Saying our content's got worse, you prick?
Nah, I'm just trying to think back. Like I've got some good moments, but I don't know.
We're gonna go back and watch the video again. The videos again, even, which I've not started doing yet, so I've probably got on that.
Yeah, I haven't even set like who's watching. I haven't even set who's watching what months yet.
Because like we agreed that that's what we're gonna do, and then we just didn't do anything about it.
Yeah.
That seems to be the Badger Impulse way.
Yeah, it's the same as the other day that we spent. Like Ross was like, "Oh, do you want to record some chatterblocks, or do you just want to make the new intro?" And we spent, 45 minutes making that 30-second intro?
No, so we spent, like, 10 minutes making... Either. We spent, like, 10 minutes making that intro, then we spent, like, 45 minutes just fucking about.
Yeah. It's 30 seconds and 2 milliseconds long, Jimmy. For fuck's sake. Get it right over here, man. I can't tell you how many times I've watched this fucking intro today, by the way.
A lot, I'm guessing.
Yeah, like, just through editing and then, like, selection and then... putting different music to it. Like, I narrowed it down to the two I gave you guys the choice of.
Yeah, I imagine you were fucking around with a lot of different ideas.
Mm-hmm.
All the ideas.
There were minis.
I must strengthen the wards. But I'm playing Neverwinter.
Fucking, I've been, like, neck deep in Skyrim again. Kind of enjoying
it. Yeah, I've not been... I've got it again, though. I've not been grabbed in it as much as I thought I would be.
I've been playing.
In saying that, I think the only reason I've not went back and played it a couple of days is because fucking what happened last time I was playing it, like right at the end of my last session, which made me have to fucking reload stuff and go back and do it. Long story short, I accidentally shot it in the face with an arrow.
God knows.
I actually have a game clip of because I was that fucking annoyed about it. Wait, I just killed a dragon. I was fighting some fucking, what's it called again? Hagravens or something. I was fighting a couple of them, along with some, what are those guys called that are always hanging about with the Hagravens? Horseworn.
Aye, that's them.
Fighting a bunch of them. Lydia got fucking put into that sort of wee crawling thing she does.
Yeah, she's low on health.
Yeah. I'm winding up my shot. Got the wee Forsworn cunt, you know, lined up. Right as I release the shot, she fucking crawls in front of me. Catches an arrow fucking right between the eyes. Fuck's sake.
You play Skyrim really similarly to how I do, eh, Alex? Like, fucking...
You eat stealthy arrows.
Yeah, like, it's near identical. I've never played with, like, all the different DLCs installed. And I just never had them on the 360. I've gotten to like the Dawnguard DLC now. Like I kind of went back into it, finished the main quest, and now I'm deciding that like I'm doing the Dawnguard DLC just now. Then I'll do the Dragonborn DLC, and then I'm just gonna mop up like all the like alternative quests and the fucking side.
See the Dawnguard DLC and the Dragonborn DLC decided to try and fuck me over all at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Know how, like, when the 360 when Dawnguard first came out and you had it installed, fucking, like, vampires would start fucking attacking towns and that shit when you got there?
Yeah, but then you were also, like, level fucking 500. So it didn't matter.
Yeah, like, on the 360 that was fine.
Yeah, because it came out later.
And then when the Dragonborn DLC came out, the fucking, there was these two dragon cultists would start, like, fucking attacking you.
Yeah.
I loaded up my save at level 5. Fast travel to Whiterun. You'll be greeted by vampires and cultists.
Oh, you got the two together?
I got both of them together.
Oh, you got a fucking shat on.
See,
I had to reload. I had to fucking reload that save 6 fucking times to beat them.
Yeah, they're a fucking pain in the ass. I remember meeting the cultists on their own at one point, like at the base of like High Hrothgar, and fucking it was so annoying. Like I had to run back and get into the town and kind of try and make the guards deal with them. I think at one point I just got far enough away from them that I fast travelled away and then fast travelled back and they weren't there.
Yeah, so that's one way to go about it. The one that really fucked me up with that is it wasn't Whiterun, it was Riverwood.
Oh, that's even worse.
Yeah. Basically shit happened and folk died.
Yeah.
Like villagers died. So I got like 200 gold for fuck all because my guys liked me. the blacksmith died. So did his wife.
Oh no.
So I was like,
his wife died to a dragon in my game just now.
Yeah. So I was like, fuck it, I'll raid their house. They're all dead. Next time I'm in fucking Riverwood, I'm coming out of the inn after dealing with the main quest line. And fucking hired thugs come at me. So I fucking murder them after like 3 attempts because they kept fucking dying. / I kept shooting in the fucking face. So I go through all that, get the fucking note off them to see who the fuck hit them after me. It was the fucking blacksmith's daughter because I raided their house. I was like, oh yeah, they're the fucking Wayne. Bastards.
That's fucking funny. I love Skyrim for like how different everybody
Skyrim does stupid shit. It's great.
It's just so like it's the same game, but everybody has such a different style and everybody experiences different things. Like me and you play it really similarly, Alex, but like we experience completely different things while playing that fucking game.
Yeah.
Like, I've been really quite lucky. Like, I've ran into the cultists only once. And every time I run into the vampires, like, it's every single fucking time I fast travel to Riften or the Thieves Guild. Anytime I'm anywhere fucking near there, there's fucking vampires in the middle of town. And every single fucking time, I just hear, like, I spawn in, I hear a bunch of commotion, and then all I see is, like, guards walking away from, like, 3 dead vampires in a pile of ash. Like, it's a repeated fucking thing. Like, it's great because I get some free shit off of just, like, fucking travelling there. Because they always seem to die. Yeah,
fucking golden shit.
Yeah, they always seem to die, like, to the guards. Like, for whatever reason, a fucking master vampire and a couple of thralls and some death hounds can't fucking take out some guards in Riften. So, whatever, but it's just one of those things, like, it's so fucking weird that it just happens every single time. Although I'm hoping it'll
be... Vampires ain't what it used to be, man.
Nah.
Seems quite, ridiculous.
I'm kind of hoping that like after I finish the Dawnguard DLC they'll be a little bit less fucking common.
Yeah, hopefully.
I think they are because you like part of the Dawnguard thing is that you can go and kill them all at the end.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. Like, I didn't realize like how almost linear that DLC was because I've only played it once before and I played it from the vampire side. And pretty much like straight away like you betray like the kind of the father vampire and then you're just ending up kind of sneaking around behind his back with nobody to help you, but it's all in the name of basically not blotting out the sun forever. Blotting out the sun temporarily, sure, but not forever. But it's really weird how like I've now decided to do it from the Dawnguard side and almost immediately. Like, it started off differently, but almost immediately it becomes exactly the same fucking questline, apart from on the Dawnguard side, you have people helping you.
Yeah.
It's so fucking weird how, like, they make it seem like it's a big choice and I expected it to be different. It's near enough the same fucking questline.
But that's the thing with a lot of things like that in games. It's like, yeah, you need to make this choice about what side to help, but regardless what you do, it kind of plays out pretty similarly.
Yeah. It's just
you get very similar steps, etc.
Yeah,
it's Fallout's terrible for it.
Yeah,
it's great for it.
Fucking,
you know, Skyrim DLC I do quite like though.
Mm-hmm.
The one that lets you build the hearth Hearthstone?
Hearthstone, the houses, yeah.
Yeah, I'm currently doing that.
Fucking you would.
I like to build shit.
I've got to agree with you in a way, Ross. Like, the building of the houses and shit is actually pretty good. Like, I started building the Lakeview Manor one as well.
That's a nice house as well. Yeah.
Is it possible to deconstruct shit that you do?
I don't know.
Because I only had, like, the one... I only had, like, the one square room for the longest time. And I was busy concentrating on building the shit outside it, and I was running really low on gold and resources and stuff, and I was like, fuck it, I'll just furnish this room, and it can basically be a functional house. So there's like a fucking bed and everything right in the fucking entranceway as you go in.
Oh,
doesn't matter.
Turn the entranceway into like a... It's actually called an entryway, I've just looked at it on the game.
Mm-hmm.
And you should be able to then, like, recustomize it.
Ah, I see, right.
Because, like, for example, if I built, like, I've built a fucking alchemy tower.
Uh-huh.
If I want to, I can tear that down and replace it with, like, a bedroom or a kitchen or whatever the fuck I want.
Yeah.
Mm.
So I imagine the same would work for the entry house.
I'm hoping so, because, like, at the moment, it's just, like, I've only just put the grand hall in, like, the main hall, but there's fuck all in it.
Green too. Yeah.
So... You walk in, and there's a fire pit and a bed and then a door, and then the door opens to a massive fucking space with fuck all in it.
Yep.
It just looks fucking nice. Ridiculous.
Yeah, it's... I think you are able to do that.
Yeah. Fucking... Shawnee's been watching me play Skyrim the last couple of nights, like, quite intensely, and she's like, I hate it when I watch you play Skyrim, because it makes me want to play Skyrim, but it makes me want to be able to play Skyrim like you do, because you play it smart.
Fucking, I need to play Skyrim though. Simply never want to. Don't need to fucking play Skyrim. I've got a pizza on the way. Happy fucking days.
What type of pizza?
Cheese.
Classic. Nice. You cannot be.
Yeah. No, you can't.
With
garlic dip. Damn it.
And cheese, chips and cheese because I'm a fat fuck.
Yeah, that's
acceptable.
It's fairly fat.
To be fair, this will be like the most I've eaten in like 2 weeks because I've been ill as fuck.
Yeah, what's up with you?
My body just doesn't. Only way I can describe it. I've spent like the last 2 weeks both at home and at work with my head in the fucking toilet.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Your body is really tearing itself apart.
Yeah, it doesn't. What can you fucking do?
Go build a house in Skyrim. That's what you can do.
No, I'm gonna go. Kill that fucking dragon without shooting Lydia in the face again. Hopefully. I'll send you that game clip in case you want to fucking try and throw it into something. Give Jamie more to do.
Fucking, I always send Lydia to my house. Like, you're a house bitch. You go do house stuff.
I've even bought a house yet.
Yeah, I've built mine. That's why I do it.
Fucking, I'm only level 13, so I only had the game like fucking a week, been playing it on and off.
I just hit level 30 with my guy today. Fucking, the crossbow is fucking OP as fuck. Versus.
Oh yeah, so once you get the exploding dwarven bolts as well.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah, like
this is the whole side of the game I've yet to discover. Exploding crossbow bolts.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you get the dwarven crossbow bolts, they fucking deagle boom.
Yeah.
Did not know that.
It's pretty.
I love that I'm still figuring shit out about this game years later.
Yeah. How old is Skyrim now?
Very old.
Very old.
Fucking. 6-7 years? 6 years old, roughly, what I say? 2000 and something?
It was...
And Skyrim
Age of the Dragon?
Yeah, it's got to be about that, because I know it was about the time that Barbara and that got hired at Rooster Teeth that the game came out.
Mm.
I suppose that, yeah. Hold on. 2011.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, 2011.
Yeah, because I remember Christmas 2011, winter. It's like when you're getting it shortly after Christmas.
Yeah, November. Seeing it there.
No, shortly before Christmas, rather.
Fucking, it's coming to a Nintendo Switch. Fuck, Jesus Christ.
Oh, fucking things what I'm not going to buy.
Have you seen the fucking cable for that shit?
Tell you what, I am
going to... just... What?
Tell you what I am going to buy, though, is a fucking Wii U at some point soon.
Oh, yeah, Mario Party.
Well, yeah, it's just like we're gonna.
I just domed the fucking guard. God damn it.
We're gonna have our own flat soon. Like we're gonna need to have things to bring people round for. Like it's fucking Mario Kart, Smash Brothers.
Yeah, because you and Sean aren't good enough for us to fucking make the travel.
The travel.
They have something for us to do. Travel, you fucking dick. I work good, you though.
Sure, go with that.
Hey, yeah, achievement.
I'm very close to this dragon. That's a problem.
Nah. I'll tell you what else I've seen today.
Squish a little, could you? What you seen?
I seen a taxi driver going fucking apeshit at a van driver today.
Yeah?
Yeah. I was in getting petrol at a petrol station. I don't know why I didn't want to name it there. I was at Asda's getting petrol. Other supermarket petrol facilities are available. But
I mean, don't get supermarket petrol because it's usually shitty quality.
It was fucking cheap and I wanted to buy a house. Need that money.
Yeah, but like when your engine goes bang from using really shitty petrol.
I normally don't, to be honest. It's like a once in a fucking while thing.
Yeah.
I actually just go fuck it. I'm here. I'll get the cheap petrol.
I'm back, you pussy dragon fuck.
What was I even saying? Oh, taxi driver. Taxi driver, right, so I'm in, like, there's four lanes in this fucking, in the petrol, four sets of pumps.
Uh-huh.
The taxi driver's in the very left-hand side, and the van driver's, like, immediately to his right. Okay. And I'm over on the far right, so I can watch all this shit. And I don't know what the fuck's going on, but the taxi driver is just shouting and swearing at the guy in the van from his taxi. Taxi driver, as far as I'm aware, didn't actually get out of his fucking taxi to ever get fuel. He's just pulled alongside the van and shouted abuse at the guy in the van.
Right, okay.
So the guy's sitting, filling up the van, just fucking shaking his head at this guy in the taxi. Fucking gets done filling up the van, gets back in the van to then go up to the window to pay for his fuel. And the fucking taxi driver pulls alongside him, still fucking shouting abuse at him while he's trying to pay for his shit. Like, basically follows him right the way around as far as he can go. And then, like, he cuts him off. Like, when you come out from the kiosk, there's, like, a tiny corner. The taxi driver, like, comes round in front of him, cuts him off, stops the taxi. He gets out and just fucking kicks the front of the van, gets back in his taxi and drives off.
Oh, nice.
Like, that ordeal took, like, maybe 10 minutes to fucking go down. Like, 10 full minutes of the taxi driver losing the shit at this guy in a van.
Any idea what he was losing his shit about?
Literally not a fucking clue. He was just shouting and swearing. And I really wish that I knew, because it's just so out of context, it was just bizarre.
Here's the thing, given that it's both a taxi driver and a van driver, both known for being absolute fucking dickheads.
Yeah.
It was probably a road rage related issue.
Well, I was thinking that. I was thinking maybe that van driver cut him up as he was, like, going in someplace, and he's just decided to, you know, waste a lot of his time during the day fucking following this guy around.
I had a little bit of road rage the other day.
Fucking, you've passed your test. Yeah. Shout out to that,
by
the way.
I passed my test, yeah.
Is that why I lead you?
No. Well, no, he wasn't. I was out driving in the snow.
Mm-hmm. Always fun.
Always fun, yeah. So... I go and decide that instead of going up the really steep hill in a very little car, that I would take the slightly more shallow hill so that there's less likeliness of the car, you know, losing grip and sliding back down the hill.
Yeah.
Thinking me being clever. Right? Get to the end of that road and there's a left-hand turn onto the main road that I'm about to take. And I take said turn. And as I take said turn, some arsehole... and our fucking shitty little red fucking Fiat 500, right? So
yes, Ross is driving a Toyota Argo out there.
Yeah. But to be fair, right, me driving that car is funny as fuck. Yes. It's me sitting behind the wheel, blaring Slipknot as loud as I can in this tiny, shitty little Toyota Argo.
Little lady car.
Yeah. But it didn't cost me anything to get insured on it, so it's fine.
Yeah.
So I take my left, and then on my right, after I've taken that left, there's a junction maybe 20 feet.
Mm-hmm.
So I turn left, start to accelerate, and she just pulls it in front of me in the snow.
Yeah, folk don't think, man.
No, they don't. I don't know if she was either A, thinking that, oh, the snow won't impede my acceleration at all, I'll just drive like normal. Or if she was just like, nah, fuck this, I can get out quicker than he can speed up. But either way, she nearly got my fucking boot of her backside. I was not a happy bunny.
Fucking see me.
Fucking road rage is like, it's the worst. I hate myself for getting it at some people sometimes.
Well, see, I got it then because I had to do an emergency stop in the snow. So, of course, the car fucking skidded.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I had Jess in the car with me as well.
It was like a protective instinct as well. Yes. There.
You've tried to hurt the thing that brings me pleasure. I will kill you.
I don't typically get road rage, like, causing the wanker every now and again. If he gets under the finger.
I just do that. Like, that's part of me. He's a wanker. He's a tit.
I do that typically anyway, so, you know.
Like, Jamie won't know this, but if you're ever in the car with me, like, Jamie might get this. When I'm driving down the road and I see a car pull up to a junction that I'm about to pass, I immediately in my head go, how's this cunt going to try and kill me?
yeah, but like, you've got that slowing wind, don't you, because you're a fucking biker?
Yeah.
You're sitting there on the fucking cage, he's like, yeah, let's kill this cunt. He's not biker, I don't fucking care.
I think you have told me that before, Ross, to be honest.
Maybe.
I feel like you brought it up after driving to mine at one point on a Monday.
Possibly.
Like, all the stories of you. Everything.
No, you know when it came up?
Yeah.
It was one time I was in the car with you, and you commented on the fact that I was checking. Like, we were coming up to a roundabout.
Yeah.
And I saw a car coming that you hadn't saw, and I went, you know, Jamie, stop. And then you noticed the car, and you were like, I can't believe you saw that. And I didn't. I'm usually really good. And I was like, well, yeah, just look for the next idiot that's going to try and kill me. And that was him. That's
it. You should be doing anyway, Jimmy. Fucking look for folk looking to kill you.
Yeah?
You'll always be looking for folk looking to kill you.
I am. Fucking... no human is perfect. You miss things occasionally. Nah.
Yeah. I mean, I think I get it for, like, I used to cycle fucking everywhere. I think I get it for that. Because let's be honest here, if you're on a fucking bicycle, people give even less fucks about you than they do if you're on a fucking motorbike.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, being on a bike's fucking scary as shit.
Yeah, it's great fun. Don't really fire at me, Argonaut cunt.
It's typically, like, it's pretty bad, like, round where I live. Like, if you go out, like, country roads-wise, it's just ridiculous because, like, there's a lot of blind corners and people just come fucking flying round.
Well, perfect example, Jimmy, is the fucking street you'd live on.
Yes.
To get out onto the main road, right?
Yeah, that's blind as fuck.
That's blind as fuck. And then you've got, like, the next turn onto the next main road.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, if you're turning left, it's okay.
Uh-huh.
But if you're turning right and someone comes from the right, they're, like, they don't give a shit that they have to slow down because they're now going into, you know, a residential. They'll just carry on at the fucking 60 speed for a wee bit.
Yeah. Yeah, that road is particularly bad. Be fucking moving soon, though. You won't have that complaint soon.
Yeah, but then we'll have the complaint of we can't see over that fucking wall.
I fucking hate that wall. I'm going to hate that flat so much. No, I'm going to love it. It's going to be great. But that fucking wall, it's coming down. It's going down like Trump's wall.
Fucking, there's...
That's going up, technically.
Yeah.
Fucking, he's...
Mexico ain't paying for it, though.
No.
Fucking, he's paying something stupid amount of money. Shawnee said it today. He's paying fucking mad amounts of money for it.
Fucking, he's just
I don't see him serving a full term, if I'm being honest with you.
Yeah.
I think he'll be impeached.
Oh, yeah, probably. Like, he's making a lot of fucking questionable things. There's so much shit against him already.
I mean,
his first
9 fucking days, he pissed off, like, everyone.
Yeah.
Well, fucking, he put a ban on fucking people from certain countries entering his.
Yeah, which is, actually goes against... like, fucking, a couple of things. Geneva Convention, I'm sure.
Yeah.
So that's something you mentioned.
Yeah, I'm fucking pretty sure
the UN have condemned it. Now the UN have condemned it, said that you can't do that, fucking illegal. A couple of judges in the States have said, no, you can't do that, it's fucking illegal.
Fucking.
We'll see how shit goes.
I just can't. Like, that's like me being the fucking Prime Minister.
It's worse.
No. You're not a narcissistic, volatile prick.
I'll give you that.
We'll both agree, Satchel.
I like how you went from that to, ooh, Satchel.
Yeah, then the both agree, Satchel.
And he's Garlic a quicksilver.
Fucking loads of that in the fucking Black Reach. Loads of good ores in there.
Mm.
And the Crimson Nurn, and the Crimson Nurn root. I always find my fucking mouth looks like it wants to stroke out when I try and say, like, all the different fucking shit.
Chicken!
Not chicken. Like, Nurn root. That's one thing that just makes me stroke out. Fuck! I can't speak at all today.
What's going on over? What is this? There's a Rami.
A Rami?
A Rami.
Somebody died. Who died?
A Rami?
Oh, it's Sven. Sven died.
Oh, yeah, that's who I got fucking 200 gold. Yeah. For, like, no one, basically. Ah.
Fucking, such a good game. GTA's got fucking cash card deals on again.
Yeah.
Not fucking horror.
Yeah, they're,
It's like they want to make money.
Yeah. Mm. They came out recently and said that they've made more money on the cash cards than they've made on releasing the GTA on PC and re-releasing it on Xbox One PS4. What the fuck is making that noise?
What the fuck is that?
I heard it too. What the fuck was that?
What the fuck made that noise?
What the fuck?
Someone got a baby?
Not to my knowledge. Not yet.
Can I eat it?
I ate a baby.
Look, I think they watch it there. I love that bastard, man. He's so good.
Austin Powers. So a fucking treat. Has anybody been watching 11 Little Roosters?
No.
I have not been either. It's one of those things, like, I just don't know. Like, I watched 10. I don't know. Did you guys all watch 10?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I kind of got into
the last one.
Yeah.
I can't remember what it was called.
I got into 10.
Walker's Dagger.
But this one I just can't get into at all. It just feels weird.
I'm just like, when it comes to RT content these days, I watch Red vs. Blue. That's about it. The odd fucking Achievement Hunter video, because they just ain't what they used to be.
Nah, I'm proper right back into watching all the Let's Plays. Mm. Like, I almost think that they're, in a way for me, they're certainly finding their stride again. Like a lot of the last, not so much the Minecraft ones. I feel like they're still probably a bit burnt out on them, but fucking who wouldn't be after like what? Nearly 300 episodes probably now.
Yeah. I've not been as into Rooster Teeth since Ray left. I think I've said that a few times before.
You have.
I just, well, not Rooster Teeth, but just the Achievement Hunter. It's fucking funny.
He was good.
He was. I rewatched some of the mini golfs today.
Oh yeah, I spent a couple of nights watching all of them.
They're fucking good.
I take you cheat.
I can't wait until we eventually get around to doing that. Which, let's face it, we probably will.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, we enjoyed just fucking playing it together.
Yeah, we tried to at one point.
Mm.
But then that was the time that all of my gear was deciding to take a fucking stroke.
Yeah, it did.
We got nothing done.
Yeah. We did fuck all.
That was fucking frustrating.
No, wait. We did. We got quite a few tweets out of that day.
Yeah.
We got the auxiliary content out of the day.
You got a video of me fucking playing Master Puppets, not 12 string acoustic guitar.
I think I salvaged something that day. Its value, I'll let the audience decide. But
are you,
I did something.
Fucking, you heard it here first. Colin, you can go back and tell us whether you're valid or not.
Yeah, God's you, it's only you.
I can't remember this fucking puzzle. I can't remember where to look for it.
What's the puzzle?
Oh, wait.
Up, down, left, right, A, B, start.
That's not it. Fuck you.
Alex, what are you doing?
It's, I'm trying to get in the fucking Alduin's wall.
Oh, yeah. Good luck. I can't remember that.
I can't remember the fucking symbols.
What, a cow in my house?
Cow? House?
Not a very nice way to talk about Jess.
Speaking of her. I've also got a chicken.
How do you get animals? Do they just come along at certain points, or...?
No, you need to hire a cow, a house carl.
Oh, I thought for a split second you were going to say a cow handler.
I can, I handle the cow.
Ross,
man, that's how fucking... a cow handler would speak.
Have you guys seen that video, The Man in the Red Mask?
No.
It's a song. It's fucking gold. It's basically about a cattle molester.
Right.
It's fantastic. I can't play it, obviously, because it's... Well, it's not... Yes, it is. I don't know. It's on YouTube.
It's there. I mean, we could fucking link... If you send me the link, I'll put the link...
I'll link to it.
Yeah. We'll put the link in the description. Fucking... What's everybody's, like, sort of Badger and Pals-related goals this year?
I discussed mine some point ago. Fucking viewers.
I would say the same. I'd also like to get the website sorted.
That's fully underway.
Yeah, I know. I'd like to get it done.
That sort of meet the team thing that you put up with, like, the 40s years.
Uh-huh.
Well, 40 of you two and then a possum. Fucking, that ended me, man.
It's fucking good.
That was fucking creased
yeah,
it.
That was fucking good. Yeah.
Like, and it's all Shawnee. Like, she's been working on the website pretty fucking solidly.
Mm.
She's been, like, it's her quiet time, like, because it's kind of after New Year, but she's still got holidays that she needs to take before March, so she's off, like, a fucking load right now.
Mm.
That change to the website isn't actually on the website yet, is it?
What?
The About Us section.
Well, no, because that's made using a completely different creator.
I know. That's... Right, just in case folk went looking for it.
Yeah.
Which I highly doubt they fucking will.
No. The website, as it has stood, will still be there as it is for the moment. But we're looking at changing up which creator we use. It basically changes who we pay, but the domain still remains ours.
Rough.
But I think really I just need to look into the logistics a little bit more of actually moving the domain. And then we just need to make sure that we cancel the GoDaddy creator. And then I think, honestly, that would kind of be the switch done, because the website doesn't cost you anything. I think until it's actually worth the traffic that visits it.
Yeah.
It's kind of weird. Like, it doesn't actually start costing you money until it's worth you to have it.
Yeah. We do we get a fair bit of traffic from China.
Yeah, it'll be fucking not with bots.
Yeah, it's still traffic, is it?
Maybe they're looking for something to eat.
Maybe.
They think it's like some kind of weird fucking friendly restaurant where you cook up.
Oh, that because we've mentioned, like, Trump before, looking for fucking secrets so they can go to war with a cunt. Lydia, will you fucking move? Thank you.
Fucking, this podcast is getting political.
I mean, we started off by saying so many things that we wouldn't tackle. Like...
No, fuck that, man. If it's happening in the world, we should tackle it.
I think we should tackle everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I'm fully... Wait, I'm fully in agreement of it.
Because, like, that was something that didn't annoy me, per se. But, maybe when I went in that, we sort of fucking anti... What?
None.
Fuck you, dude. Fuck you and your average-sized fingers, you cunt.
My normal-sized hands.
Yeah. I've been through this. My hands are normal size, my fingers aren't. Difference. I've got man palms and baby fingers.
Baby flip through.
Midget digits.
Still, yeah. I still really want you to start a band that's called that.
I'm too tall.
Start a band?
Not by much. Yeah. But I can need to be at least, like, up, at most, like, 5'2". Absolutely not how it works, but hey, fuck it.
Yeah. Anyway, Alex, what annoys you?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I was making a point there, wasn't I?
Yeah.
when...
Oh, did you hear that?
Yeah.
Everybody
oh,
did.
Oh, that's going to stink.
Smelly bastard.
Oh.
Fucking all 16...
I'll love to eat you in a second on this.
All 16 people that watch this will enjoy yeah. that. If they've made it this far in.
When I brought up Trump... I brought up Trump a while ago. You were trying to get me not to talk about anything fucking political. And it's like, I'm trying to go on... a semi-series, but funny rant here, and you're like, no, don't fucking say that. And I'm just like, motherfucker, let me have my role.
Okay, I've, you know? I've given up controlling what happens with this fucking whole shebang.
You put me and Ross together, you cannot control what happens.
Again, it's just gonna, like, Badger and Pals is, like, now, like, the official recording of, like, our gradual 10-year descent into utter madness.
What do you mean, descent?
No, I mean
mate,
descent.
Mate, we're already like, fucking there.
No, we're mad, but like, can you imagine how fucking mental we're going to be after 10 years of this shit?
Yes.
True.
10 years more?
Fucking could it get worse?
I'd say we make it 10 years. Fucking Trump would have blown us all up by then.
Fucking it blows all up by fucking next week.
Yeah, true. Fucking man's a psychopath.
Sociopath. Difference.
Fucking he's both.
Ross, you're a psychopath.
I'm a psychopath, yes. But I'm a good...
I was reading something pretty interesting earlier, actually, while I was taking a monumental shit.
Mm-hmm.
It was about a bunch of psychologists that have come out and said that Trump may have... Oh, what was it again? Manic narcissism.
Mm-hmm.
And it adds up. I mean, he's fucking delusional for one. Thinks that everyone fucking loves him when nobody fucking likes him. And rather than actually addressing things, he just goes on like angry tirades if you fucking say what he doesn't want to hear.
Uh-huh.
That's it. That's...
I mean, it's a solid theory.
Hmm. Interesting, yeah, that's all I was getting at. Health increase. Let's put some points into sneak.
Fucking, I'm trying to fucking get everything organised for moving. I actually fucking packed some shit the other day. It actually made me realise how little I fucking have. Like, in a lot of ways.
Yeah?
Yeah, because, like, I only had, like, one small box and two semi-large boxes, and like the semi-large boxes are just filled with now what DVDs and CDs I still have, and the smaller box is just filled with like other bits and pieces and knickknacks, and like I kind of like I've got one of them beds that like it pulls up and open, like if you want to kind of dig under it for shit.
Oh yeah, they're handy.
Fucking so handy for storage. Like the underside of that was absolutely like totally fucking full, and like now it's got fucking not even maybe like a bag's worth of clothes and under it. Like there's next to fuck all under there.
Fair enough.
Also, I wanted to ask, do you think we could do anything funny with a really fucking old laptop?
Possibly. How?
Well, because I've got like a properly old, like, well, I say properly old, it's probably 2013, but that's pretty old for laptops.
As far as tech goes, that's pretty old.
Yeah, it's old as fuck. But I found, like, I actually totally forgot that I'd kept it. But it was my laptop from, like, back when I'd fucking first started college.
Mm.
And fucking the power cable from, like, my one broke. But my mum's got exactly the same laptop, so if I needed to, like, charge it to put it on, I could. I was just thinking, is there anything fucking funny that I could do with that laptop before I probably just throw it away?
What we do is we get a picture on it, you know, something we don't like.
Mm-hmm.
and then you take a running start with a fucking baseball bat and just smack it.
Oh yeah, we could do the fucking what's that film? What's the film where they trash the fucking photocopier?
What is that film?
It's something.
I can hear it's the something. Thinking.
I'll do that because Rorthan was just fucking trying to slug him, basically.
Fucking, I mean, I'm happy enough for that. Like, it is fucking worthless. There's nothing on there. Like, it's never been used for badgering pals or anything, because like, it's in your fucking laptop's courtyard for not being able to fucking sustain shit, Alex. Like, it just would not run anything if we even tried.
Look, I can watch YouTube and porn. I'm happy with
I mean, that's all you need, is it?
Yeah. Fucking,
That old laptop...
YouTube porn iTunes, I'm set.
That old laptop truly did meet its demise when I started fucking playing Sims 3 on it.
Cause that says a lot about its capability.
Yeah, exactly. Like, and, well, to be fair, The Sims is a fucking demanding game. Like, when people... When people say they want a laptop that just runs The Sims, like, that's actually a pretty fucking half-decent laptop you end up getting.
I'm happy to know my laptop will run Sims 3.
I mean, so will mine, but just not with all the fucking mods I put on it.
No, mine runs it like fucking, like, buttery smoothly, like everything. It's fantastic.
That's pretty fucking good. Mine's fucking struggles. No, the Sims are fucking ages, man. Fucking Shawnee was playing it earlier on. She was playing Sims 4 on my PC. I was sitting playing Skyrim. She was like, I'm going to play The Sims. I was like, okay. Help yourself.
But any games that... Like, I don't play it very often, but then when I do play it, I'm up for like 3 days.
Yeah, I'm exactly the same. Like, I have to try and, in a way, stop myself from doing that kind of shit, because, like, if I get into The Sims, I will play it, like, solidly for a week and then never again for years.
Yeah, that's what I end up like, because, like, you sit down on, like, Monday, and then before you know it, it's Wednesday, and you're like, I smell weird.
See, I can't play Sims anymore because I got all the achievements in Sims 3 on the Xbox 360, and it just killed it for me.
There's something just really unenjoyable about, like, The Sims after a long period of time. I suppose that's kind of the same for anything. I feel like I burnt myself out in that same way for MMOs. Like, anything that's too MMO-y that I can't play with friends, like, too, like, super regularly... I find myself really struggling to maintain. Like, Ross, you managed to get me back on the Old Republic for a grand total of 2 days.
Yeah.
Like, before it totally, like, burnt me again, and I was just like, I just don't fancy going back to it.
I think what's kept me in Neverwinter, mm-hmm. as long as I've been, I was losing interest, and I got into a guild.
I suppose that helps maintain.
Because I'm doing stuff for the guild. It's keeping me playing it, because I've got something to do every day when I go on. You know, I need to go and get resources, put them into the fucking coffer, all that sort of shit. Plus, it's a pretty friendly one as well, so, like, I talk to them and, like, play with them when the core folk are on. So, like, you know, it's not like I'm just fucking grinding out Warcraft by myself like I used to.
Yeah.
See, I've been doing that in the Old Republic. I've been grinding it out, but I have just joined a guild, and like you, Alex, they're a pretty friendly guild, so, like, today we did a couple flashpoints as a group.
Yeah. Then I know what that means.
I got some fucking awesome loot. I got a new mount. I was very happy with that.
Yeah. Because, like, what I ended up doing is, because my gear score is still pretty low, one of the guys burnt some of this, like, currency that he no longer needed, because it was well past that part of the game, and then basically bought me a new e-shirt for my character.
Nice.
Then they, oh, that's a bit cool. And they ran me through a fucking one of the epic dungeons, and I got a sweet fucking bit of armor for that as well. Note to self, when you come out of Alduin's wall, turn left. No, don't go straight.
Did you fall off the cliff?
I did.
Nice.
Survived, because fucking... Eat. I was on my feet.
Could you eat feet? Do you know what I really want us to do this year, Ross?
What do you really want us to do this year?
I really want us to have a fucking stupid shirt.
A stupid shirt?
Yeah.
Like, us having shirts to begin with is fucking stupid. We've been through this.
Yeah, it is. But I just want us to take something that one of us has said or is going to say in a future video I'd put it on a shirt with a fucking stupid cartoon with it.
See, here's how...
Did we not have fucking some shirt ideas?
We did have some shirt ideas.
But things happened and that's not viable. At least as it was going to be.
Hmm.
I don't remember what they were either, to be honest with you. Fucking, I just knew they were happening.
Yeah.
And then they weren't.
I imagine at some point we maybe have mentioned it, even on a podcast. We mentioned what the ideas might be.
But, I was standing in another vape shop, not the one I work in, because it's not going like that. I was having a conversation with somebody who was there. What's that game where you're a parent badger and you need to look after little badgers? What's that game called?
Shelter.
Yeah, she thought I was really into the game Shelter. So I was standing wearing my fucking Baps t-shirt.
That's amazing.
I had to explain, no, I'm just part of a very small, unsuccessful YouTube channel.
Hey, we are semi-successful.
What a way to sell it.
Yeah.
We're leaving cracks after subs.
Alex fucking standing, getting into conversation with somebody that recognises the shirt, and he just goes, oh yeah, it's from this unsuccessful thing, I wouldn't even bother.
No, I explained what it was, and then that was in that conversation, we went back to talking about fucking vaping.
Well, that's much more important.
Oh yeah, it's my fucking... It's my job.
My job, man.
I need no shit. You find out what's fucking coming out?
Again, I am going to put together this fucking podcast immediately after this. Well, I'm going to fucking have to.
Well, I was hoping you guys had a jigsaw. I was like, I don't know why I had this picture of you sitting doing like a fucking Thomas the Tank Engine jigsaw with like 10 pieces.
Jamie.
Yeah?
Jamie, you know who I saw the other day?
Who was that?
I was thinking you.
No. Do you remember when you used to work at the same place that I did?
Uh-huh.
There was the guy that would come in, and he must have been like in his 50s, and every week he'd buy the Thomas the Tank Engine magazine.
I think I know who you're on about, yeah.
I saw him the other day.
What's he doing with himself now?
He was reading Thomas the Tank Engine. So he's keeping up the hobby. It's been a good like 4 years, he's still going.
Fucking, you like what you like? My voice cracked the fucking belt all though. Like puberty mark too.
Fucking, Alex, do you just want me to fucking do a wee description and a tweet and everything for this as well, and I'll just set this all up tonight?
Fucking says me doing it, so
why? Fucking, this bothers me, right?
What bothers you?
A rabbit has died outside my house.
Mm-hmm.
Its fucking dead carcass won't fuck off.
Just like throw
pick up and carry it away.
Throw it down the nearest hill.
I've tried, it's like glitched into the ground.
Shout at it.
Oh, good idea, yeah.
Unrelenting force that bitch.
It didn't do anything!
I was about to say, we're away to fucking hear it.
Did you hear it?
Yeah. Nice. Fucking heard you at the anvil earlier as well.
Yeah, it's because I've got my TV coming through the soundbar.
That makes sense.
I just couldn't be fucked turning it down. That's effort.
Fucking, I'm only just meeting Parthenax, that's how far into the game I'm.
I haven't even met Parthenax yet. I keep doing other shit.
Sick. Well, before I've been doing other shit as well.
Like building a house. I built my house now, it's finished.
Okay, I ended up... Fucking, I started the quest to join the fucking... Oh, I joined the fucking Thieves Guild, actually.
Fucking, the first thing I did and was finish... The first thing I did was finish the Thieves Guild.
I haven't started, like, I need to go fucking burn down beehives, but I need to make sure I'm sober on doing that, or else I'll get emotional.
No, please. Do it drunk. So we can...
No, because drunk Alex really likes bees.
No, come on.
Film it, come on.
Please, we have to film that.
Just any kind of filming of it.
Alright. But the bees.
Rather reserved, alright.
Content.
What is that?
Said, but the content.
Oh, Ross, you haven't seen it yet? Shawnee put another page on the website the other day.
Uh-huh.
And it's the links at the top, it just says what we do. And you click on it and the first like big black banner that comes up, it just says it's content. And then you and then you scroll down and it just has Let's Play and then podcast.
Nice.
And it has a little like it will in time have like a bit of kind of, you know, what like that style of video. And what to expect from it.
And then drunk and cry at bees. That's what we do.
In time, I'm hoping we can add more. I really want our first live action production to come out this year, even if it's just a fucking clip show of us doing random shit.
That's what I want to do by the end of the year.
What?
Yeah, I'll have
North Coast 500. Yeah. I definitely want to do this year, for fucking sure. It's happening.
For sure. I'm way too late to pull it off.
Fucking aren't all of us.
Yeah, but as Jamie said the other day in a text to me, I'm nerdy white, so it's okay.
Or what?
It was a whole conversation.
Yeah,
I missed what you actually said.
Jamie, go see if you can find that conversation.
Yeah, hold on. It's because Ross said something. He said, I think you said faux shizzle. And you said.
And then I immediately apologised for it because I'm not black enough.
Yeah. Right, hold on. I will find it. It wasn't that long ago. I think it might actually be longer ago than that. No, it can't be.
It was last weekend.
I will find it.
Get it found.
I genuinely can't find it. Did you text me it or
Facebook message, I think it was.
Oh, was it Facebook message? That may be why I can't find it.
Jimmy, what are you putting over the podcast this week?
Skyrim, funnily enough.
Fucking good, because I've got a screenshot of my nicely built house for you to put in. So everyone can see
Fuck's sake, don't make it more work, it's late.
No, I'm making it more work. I'm uploading it to a OneDrive, I'm going to share it with you.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I'll be nice and fucking... not fucking...
Yep.
Send my clip up later getting domed.
I'm literally just asking you to put in a fucking screenshot.
That's still unrelenting force. Not unrelenting force, fucking whirlwind sprint. Fuck's sake, let's get your shit together.
So many things. I'm scrolling past the... Oh, yep, here we go. Here we go.
Oh, you found it, have you?
I found it, yeah. It was me and you discussing... what we were going to do the other day, because you might have come round, but then you were like, oh, I'm not really feeling up for it, but I'm going to do the short Skyrim stream.
That was fucking funny.
That was just the fucking 5 minutes at the start of that, to be honest, was worth the whole fucking thing.
Yeah, it was.
And I told you that I was going to go and receive a haircut and everything. And you said, yeah, that gives me time to do my housework and shizzle. And then immediately you said, I'm white, I'm sorry, I can't pull off that shizzle speak. And I said, fuck yeah, but we is like geek white, so nobody cares because nobody listens.
Fair.
Oh, fuck it.
There was more to that, but let's not go into it.
You can tell me later.
Yeah, I can remember what we speak about then. Fucking man, I'm gonna shit myself any minute now.
Well, you'll be happy to know, Ross. It's just about time to wrap up.
Oh, thank fuck. It's gonna be a painful one. I can tell it because that fart I had mid podcast. Like, it was
some seep out, did it?
No, it wasn't. Like, it wasn't quite eggy.
Well, I know exactly what you mean.
It was like eggy, but it was like eggy with curry.
Oh, dude, come on.
Which means this is going to sting. Like, this is going to be a hot one.
Like, your ones are proper fucking bad.
What ones?
Garlic shits.
You know what ones are really bad for me?
Uh-huh.
Ones.
If I have Domino's the night before, my post-Domino shite, it's like, oh, it's biblical. In fucking girth and solid, like, solidity. It's just, biblical.
That just makes me laugh because...
In girth!
Yeah, the fucking white. It's like my whole system backs up when I eat those ones. Eat, like, those Domino's.
What makes me laugh about that is, like, when you were down for Comic-Con, also we had the Domino's, and we were talking about... I can't mind how the conversation came up, but you just turned to us and goes, I'm just constipated.
Yeah. Can't remember that conversation either, but
again, there's so many.
Never done anything. I'm just constipated.
So many good one-liners.
Oh no! Remember now.
Yeah.
We were walking around Con, and you said, I need to go take a shit. And I was like, right, well, the toilets are just over there. And it was like day two, and you were like, those fucking toilets are like horrid. And I was like, yeah, I know. Like, they were really bad last year. I don't know what they're like this year. And you're like, you've not been yet. And I was like, nah, mate, I'm constipated. Like, you're just in the middle of the fucking con floor. Sitting talking about my bowels.
I mean, why not?
Oh, my Calydia, again.
Right.
Oh, for fuck's sake!
I keep thinking yours. I thought you said chlamydia there. What?
No.
I've got it again, god damn it!
What have you got?
Chlamydia. And on that note...
fuck's sake, man.
I'll wrap this up, shall I?
Oh, I farted again. Yeah. It's really smelly. Oh.
I just fucking shouted Lydia right off the edge of a fucking cliff.
Did you game?
I tried to kill... No, I didn't, because I just immediately reloaded because I'm so fucking annoyed. I was trying to kill an ice wraith and accidentally hit the fucking bumper.
Nice. Well, if you've enjoyed this girthy shit of a podcast...
Well, the better of a fucking effort, man.
And you can go to www.badgingpants.com. You can find links to all the other girthy shit we do.
Can we add that to the website? A poop diary for everyone. We like describe our poops for the week.
Fucking we may as well at this point. What can we tell each other anyway?
I text you.
I was thinking... get a text from Ross, I'm always like, fucking how big was it this time? But in saying that, like when I fucking I just destroyed the toilet when I got home. My first thought was, I need to tell Ross.
Yeah, you did text me, same.
Now, I want to have a living document one way or another. I don't know what we're going to put in the living document, but if it turns into a poop diary as well, why the fuck not?
Even if that's not how it's meant to be, that's what it will be.
Yeah.
Probably, yeah. It's always what ends up happening with these things.
Mm.
Right. Anyway, let's fucking wrap this shit up.
I need to poo.
Right, bye guys.
Bye guys. Almost forgot.